Hey everybody, welcome back to Torchbearer, the Sunless Citadel, where we just finished convincing a kobold queen to not kill them on the way back of after promising to recapture a dragon wormling for that belongs to these kobolds. And they're obviously, their sworn enemies are the goblin kind below. So, yeah, so... let's see. So, Arendelle, you're trying to remember something about this key, and you're trying to recall some stories from your past, or something that you've read in a book somewhere about what's going on, and what the significance of a key in a temple like this. So, this is an Ob 1 test.
Yeah, so, was anyone helping?
Oh.
I think Grice opens his mouth and he starts to like formulate a religious perspective and recall his studies, but you have this unearthly, like otherworldly face expression when you're remembering, right? It's a very uniquely elven thing, and he's just stunned into silence.
Yeah. And actually I'm actively trying to block you out because I really I'm used to, I've spent so much time alone by now. Sorry, whose sound is this? That's a bit distracting.
What sound?
I don't know.
There's a lot of noise coming from you, I think.
I think that's my cat eating. I'll mute it.
Okay, thanks. So, yeah, I've spent so much time alone that, you know, Grice is trying to, give me some types of clues, but I'm trying to block him out and trying to remember. So I'm gonna use my loner trait against me.
I want to take this as a teachable moment for TV Land fans as well. So Torchbearer has this really cool mechanic. If you guys have ever played Darkest Dungeon, you know how when you want to camp. You know how you have a certain amount of points to spend in your camp to give yourself bonuses? Think of that as a mechanic in this game in Torchbearer, where in order for you to do tests to make yourself heal or do things that to recover or other actions in camp, you need to be earning those points. So imagine instead of getting 10 points in Darkest Dungeon at the start, you get fucking 0 points, and you have to make yourself, like, do bad things and play up your traits against your own roles. Like, you have to actually... fight against succeeding. So if you invoke a trait like stubborn, right? If you use stubborn and be like, oh, I'm stubborn, I'm not taking Arendelle's help, right? Or I'm not taking Grice's help, or you know, for example, right here, right? Arendelle's like, I'm a loner, right? I'm not taking, I'm not listening to Grice. I'm focusing in my own little tunnel vision here. You can actually take a penalty to your role, but you earn yourself a check during the camp phase, which is when you can recover. Once again, and kind of heal up and that kind of stuff. So that's what's going on right now. And that's why it seems like you want to make checks against yourself, because it's really good. Especially when, if you actually have other people helping you, making a check, you know, if you get like, if you're trying to pass like a, you know, you need success, a 4, 5, or 6 for on a die, just one of them, if you roll like 6 dice, if, you know, 3 people are helping you, you can roll a total of 6 dice. You know, you can probably just do with 5 dice, right? And then you can start kind of invoking traits. And that's kind of how Torchbearer is supposed to work, is people are helping you. You're being annoying and selfish and playing out these character traits while everyone else is kind of like, you know, and when you still fail, then everyone deals with all these consequences. It's a really... Anyways, that's sort of how the game is supposed to, like, breathe. So that's teachable moment over. Thank you. Let's go.
Okay, so input value, any help, traits, supplies, conditions, or other modifiers, -1? Does it work?
Yeah, should work.
Yes.
Okay, let's see. What obstacle? Obstacle 1, he said. So let's see. There we go.
Right. Oh, cool. Yep, you got it. I don't think there's open-ended obstacles in Torchbearer. So what we see here, you totally recall stories about keys and stuff like that. And you know that there are in sort of like these sort of... cult temples. You know that when high priests are killed, they're buried in special, either like trapped or extremely secured locations. This key, based from it being in a dragon maw, seems like it would access a very important or secure location in this temple, probably regarding someone who's very important. So, like, that's on a meta level, yeah, it totally could access another part of the dungeon. That's sort of like an extra bonus thing, right? But I would like to hear maybe what actually Arendelle remembers in terms of, like, Arendelle's story of temples, right? If you want, if that's interesting.
I'm gonna
Was that helpful? Was that too obvious? Like, do you think you deserve more, like, this specific key?
Maybe if it's about the specific key, perhaps whose grave it actually is.
I would say that with obstacle one, like,
yeah,
that's like, it's a key. It looks important.
High priest, right? High priest. That's all you know. You know, it's a high priest in service of the dragon, right? The dragon that burned your town. Right.
Yeah, and this high priest was a kobold?
You don't know.
Oh, I don't know. Okay.
Probably not.
Do you remember the kobold?
No, otherwise, I could have come up with a name or like some story about him. But
no, these are from long ago.
The kobolds have only been here a few months, so.
I know this is from long ago, but elves have been here since the dawn of time.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's... Yeah. Yeah.
You remember this place like it was yesterday.
Well, yeah. When all my fellows were still alive and no one started going to the Grey Havens yet. And
I'm sorry, I have some knives. Do you maybe want to sort of?
Wait. But wait, Deckard, you don't want to use those knives because this key is actually really. This might be of interest to you because. I think we might be able to access, it was an interesting part of this citadel.
The vault?
Treasure? If the kobolds have had this key for a while, and I guess that they've guarded it quite well, I think this probably grave will not have been spoiled yet. So...
You see Gilly's eyes flare up.
Yeah.
Golden twinkle in both eyes.
So if you see this gold, imagine this tripled, quadrupled, maybe more.
They obviously would have touched it. They're just a bunch of, and Deckard looks around and sees it. Oh, crap, that's still all there. Lovely creatures who are respectful of cultures.
Is there a piece of rope or something that we can use to how big is the key? Is it like this?
Like football? Like a soccer ball? Like it's a pretty big key, maybe like
ceremonial.
Yeah, like exactly.
Key to the city?
Yeah, like I said, it was kind of like a key to the city kind of thing. To a kobold, it's like huge, right? It's like the size of like their shoulders, right? But it's very large. Or like a rugby ball would probably be the best.
Us, I guess it takes a whole pack one slot in our inventory.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So can I take...
Yeah, it's like heavy and just, you know...
Can I cut a bit of rope from my rope and tie the key around my neck?
I feel like that's cheating, Torchbearer.
I don't know. There's a neck slot.
Yeah, there is a neck slot.
What else are we going to use it for?
I mean, this is my first time GMing Torchbearer in like a serious adventure. Normally, like skirting the rules of inventory is probably not the best. I feel like maybe this is a test then. I feel like that would be fair.
Whoa.
A peasant test?
I don't know.
I can do a peasant test. I'm learning peasant. Yeah. I want to be a peasant. Let me be a peasant.
but it's a test.
I want to get my axe and hang it around my neck, and then maybe get my shield and wear it on my head. And
yeah, that's the problem. I'm not quite sure.
You're the DM, Eric.
I don't think I'll let it.
I think this key is either big enough that it's too heavy and too awkward to wear as like an amulet, or it's doable.
Yeah, you're not the dude who can.
That's why I asked.
Yeah, you don't wear. You're not Flavor Flav. You can't wear like a clock around your neck, right?
I'm a really cool elf.
Hold on.
If you took trait, if you had Flavor Flav wise, maybe.
These little salt flies.
Yeah.
But anyone who have one or two slots of bag space?
One slot bag space.
Anyone? I have bag space. Anyone else?
I see those.
It depends. If you're willing to let me use the key as a weapon, then I can carry it in my
This hand. Is a heavy key worth at least 2 die worth of treasure. Right? Like, it's gold. It's solid gold, right?
Not nothing, but it's probably worth more to keep it.
Look, we can throw away a grappling hook and then I could carry it, but...
But I have room in my satchel.
I'm waiting for when things get really bad and you're stuck and you're like, can I use the key as a grappling hook?
Yeah.
Arendelle, if it's too much bother for you, I can trade you this mirror and you could put that in your satchel and it would
I already have a mirror.
Then you'd have two mirrors and then I get to carry the key for you, much like I was carrying the rations for you.
Why do we need two mirrors? Your makeup is fine. Dump one of them and use the key.
It's fine. Give me the mirror, you can have the key.
Sounds like a good idea. I like that idea.
Hold up, we're giving the halfling the golden key?
Yeah, why not? He can easily hide.
Yeah, that's the problem. He can
I can easily hide because I'm short, is that what you're saying? It's because I'm short that I can hide?
That's exactly what I'm saying. Yeah. You buddy, you, stay in my sight.
Look, I start to sort of stand up on my toes, so I'm sort of at equal height as Deckard, so look him straight in the eyes, go, okay.
Square some shoulders so I'm double the width.
Gilly, this was a compliment. This wasn't meant as an insult.
He just stares at you and walks away.
Enough of this petty squabbling. Your Majesty, might we talk to your goblin prisoners? We feel interrogating them might allow us to... better ascertain their ill intent.
I've got just a quick question about the lantern. Is the room lit? Because if it's lit, I'm going to douse the lantern.
It is lit. It has one turn left.
I'm dousing the lantern for now then. So we have one more turn on the lantern.
Okay. Well, then I'll leave it at one, but I'll make sure it's remembered as it's...
All right, thanks.
So does Estrelle lead us to the goblin prisoners? Does she allow that?
Yo, yeah. You have access to the camp, right? So you want to go talk to the prisoners?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so there's definitely a stockade of some wretched goblins. They're kind of near the rats, and they all like are huddled in a corner, nearly naked.
I'll sort of nudge Grice before we go there and go like, good cop, bad cop? Is that, good cop, good cop? Who do you want to be?
I think in this situation, my skills would be best suited to the bad cop.
All right, I can deal with that. I can be very nice. I can be very tactful. It's gonna go swimmingly.
You seem more on a level with them.
I have a question for Eric. In my background, I wrote that goblins were working with the dragon when they destroyed my town. Did that happen, or did you sort of get that I wrote that? Because that sort of influences how I react to goblins.
Well, you would know, just like kobolds, there's different tribes of goblins.
Of course, yeah.
These ones are bearing different markings than those.
Okay, good. Yeah. That's what
good I question, know. Though. Yeah, no, it's a solid question.
Still filthy kobolds, though.
Yeah, no, these guys have a different... They're of a different tribe. In fact, you probably realize, like, whatever scraps they have of clothing, they actually probably still, like, try to draw their symbol on it. Or maybe the symbol's on the wall. And it looks kind of like the sprays of, like, the Joker. You know, like the eyes and like the big smile. Only it's supposed to be more like a goblin face. It's a very crudely drawn goblin face.
Yep.
There's goblin, and like they wrote something below the symbol. You don't under. I mean, if you don't read goblin, you don't know what it is. But it's probably associated with the symbol, right? I mean, that's pretty obvious.
I think
you don't have to be a linguist to get that.
I've deciphered two goblin rune writings already. Does that sort of at some point give me some?
Like I let it ride.
Well, I don't know, but is there like linguist? Is that a skill, or because how do you at one point do you start recognizing more? If I know something, do I know something else?
I think when you level up and stuff, you could gain goblin wise. You actually could gain that.
Oh, so I like that way. Okay, yeah.
You're going to add something, Alex?
No, just that.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. Thanks.
No, you could totally test scholar to read what it says, or you could actually like, you know, try to converse with the goblins. Because remember, you're going to be using down your turns, right? Like it's still going to take turns. You're still in the dungeon. What would you like to do?
Sorry, turns? You mean like downtime turn?
You have two turns until the grind happens, where you guys all get hungry. And
oh yeah. So two tests.
Yeah.
So I think Grice, Grice and Deckard walk up to the cages and examine these goblins. How many are in there?
There are five.
And do they pay any attention as we approach?
Yeah, they well, you douse the lantern, but they're still like, which makes sense because there's still lights in this place that lit by the kobolds, right? And their own like braziers and stuff, but like away, like they're the kobolds immediately all like scour into like the dark corners like rats. When you get close, they like hiss like.
All right, I guess Decker just walks up to a cage like full of confidence of what they're gonna do. Just stand in front of it. Taking care, experience with this kind of thing to make sure to get distance out of, clawy grab reach. Just as I go, sup, fellas? How are you doing there? Doing okay?
Yeah, they just hiss, right?
Now, come on. I know at least one of you speaks common. Huh?
Yeah, they're eyeing you suspiciously. Right?
Okay, so
think your life's not miserable enough? Well, just imagine how much worse it's gonna get if one of you fuckers doesn't speak up.
Bryce sort of leans in, like
hungry,
heavy.
One of them's like hungry, and like hungry.
Have they not been feeding you?
Hungry.
You want some? Look, I'm sure I have something here, but the thing is, and I grab some rations. Like, hungry? This is.
Yeah, and they all start like clamoring and like fighting over each other, like trying to get close to the bars.
And Grice will lean in, and he'll take the ration from Deckard and hold it like in his hand and just break off and start eating it. And it's like just conspicuously devouring it. At a talk, you little fuckers.
And they get super angry, right? They're like, "No! No, my food! Food! Food!" And like the kobolds, like the guards are coming over now and they're like, "Wait. Like don't like stop getting them all angry and wild."
It'll be fine. It'll be fine. And
right, Grice.
Yeah.
Looking at Grice's sappy robe.
Okay. And like one of them is like, okay, hungry. Okay. Me.
Sure, all for you. But look at it. Look at how quickly he's eating. You'd better have some answers before he stops eating. Because if he's, that's it. That's it.
Stop.
Yeah, he's wasting. Like, me.
Who?
Okay, right. You. What do you know about the dragon?
Prisoner. Our prisoner.
Yeah, your prisoner. Where is he? Where's prisoner?
He points to the goblin face. Prisoner. Like, and goblins have him.
Goblins have prisoner. Okay. Where? Where?
And he's like pointing to the symbol, like, because he can't, he doesn't, he's really, you know, he doesn't know English that well or common. So he's just like, signaling that he's in their camp, right? Like, yeah. Like the goblin tribe has the dragon. Now he's like holding hands out for food.
I guess they don't want food. This is not clear.
Leave him, Deckard. Told you they don't know. They don't know shit.
Right, you liars.
Like an entire.
You're all liars.
Like hard tack and just shoves it in his face.
So you just eat a ration just to spite them.
Stop wasting the food.
So, no, I don't think like one piece of hard tack is a ration. If you know what it is, I will
no,
do it.
No.
It's just Gilly constantly tugging your clothes.
Another goblin in the back says, "See, the long shanks are all liars." That's what I told you.
Arendelle pokes or nudges Grice and says, "Perhaps we can get the queen to give us one of those goblins to act as a guide. We can keep him on a leash.
That would work."
I don't know. I trust them less than I trust the kobolds.
I want to point out the one. There was one at the back who said, "See, they're all liars."
Yeah, like he's way more intelligent. Yeah,
exactly. So I'm like, you know common speech. Come over here. Why? Come on, buddy. You
Fuck
know
off.
More.
We have food.
You're not hungry?
We're dead goblins.
Maybe. I mean, if we leave, absolutely. These kobolds don't care about you. I'll be honest.
You don't care about us. You're selfish.
I don't.
You're all selfish. You kicked the master out. You hate the master. You hate goblins. You hate everyone. You're the worst.
That is absolutely true. But here's who I hate a little bit less. I'm after someone. I don't care that much about you. I care about capturing someone. So... how about we work something out that works for the both of us? You help us find out where that asshole went to, and I don't care what happens to you next. Run off, just marry your sister, I don't know, but if you help me out, I can help you out here.
Don't listen to him.
Deckard, ask if the other prisoners are still alive. It's more important.
Don't listen to him. He's not going to help you. You're right. We are selfish. We don't give two bits whether you live or die. What you've got now is a chance to not die hungry. That's what's on offer here. Nothing more.
He's fucking making it fight against its own proud nature.
Deckard at this point kind of wants to shove Kelly a little bit to the side. Grown up stalking boy.
Who is the master?
Part of me thinks that one of the goblins will end up killing the one that won't help you, and literally like come up like, "I'll help you," you know, me. Like, I don't want to die hungry, you know. I think that's probably maybe what happens. I think one of them kills that one that was like really like eloquent. And just literally just like rips his fucking throat out and just then comes over and like with bloody hands like, "Me. I help." get me out, I help. like fucking shameless.
Gideon walks forward, takes a step forward, and he points to another goblin and says, we'll take that one over you. Because your hands are all we'll take the other one. That's okay.
Deckard sort of leans.
Kobolds, no. The kobolds will not let you take a goblin.
That wasn't part of our deal.
Wasn't part of the deal. They're their prisoners. They think that you might abscond with them, right?
Yeah.
They're planning to eat them or something, right?
Yeah.
So.
Or you? No. They're like, no. There are food. Be your own food, Longshanks.
Okay, so Deckard leans in.
Look, you already killed one of them. Nah, that one's gotta go in the stew. Like, come on.
I asked Deckard the...
Oh yeah, go ahead.
No, I asked the badass goblin. Do you know who the outcast is?
Master.
And who is this master?
He's like you. No, and he's pointing to directly over to Grice, right?
Yeah, and we see Grice's eyes like narrow, and he frowns. He knows exactly who.
Belak is what he says.
Hold on,
he says Belak. He says
my
leader Balsog Belak. Like Balsog is like here, and then he's like he's like. Balsog, Belak, Outcast, Balsog.
Does your leader Balsog have our prisoners? I mean, the people we're looking for.
He's prisoners.
People, Dragon? You catch people like, and he points to Grice. Like, they live. They're heartbeat.
Belak take them.
Oh, they are alive. See, I told you they were alive. Gilly passes, looks around the room to everyone. Says, see, I told you they were alive. No one even believe me.
Who cares? It says alive.
Balsog want to eat, but Belak say no.
He sounds like a sensible person.
Who's Belak?
He's like Belak. Looking at you like the master. Yeah, the outcast.
Belak.
Belak, and he's like, now, you know, he's pointing. Whenever you say, like, who's Belak, he points to Grice.
Yeah.
So I turn to Grice, like, who's Belak? What's going on here?
My nemesis. He was cast out from the enclave of the perennial world tree. Or maybe he's just gone astray. Officially excommunicated. A rogue branch, you could say.
Fuck.
How long have you been sitting on that one?
Just top of my
a
head,
rogue yeah. branch of yeah, a heretical branch of the World Tree religion. Yup.
Nice.
Well, okay. I know who's getting a persona.
Right, more religious nut jobs. Fine. Whatever.
Yes.
Right, okay.
Belak and tree. It's his tree.
And I think Grice makes, you know, like he makes the sign of the tree or whatever.
He makes the tree upside down.
And like he's visibly like upset by this. This is utter heresy.
Yeah.
And I think like he makes the sign of the tree again, and like he spits and he rubs his hands onto his like sap soaked robes and anoints himself with the sacred sap once more, because it's just like the below tree is just
it's defiling.
It, like, irritates every fiber of his being.
Yes.
You're a disgusting creature. Have some food. And he tosses him like the last little bit of that
of the tashin. Yeah.
Yeah.
And you see like the other goblins clamor, and he just like fucking like punches one of them and like starts like eats to put in his mouth and invites him off. It's like you tell You tell Nahoon. You tell Nahoon.
Is he speaking goblinch?
Yeah, he's goblin-ish? Like, no, you like you don't really understand what he's saying, but he's like, you tell Nahoon. Like he does this symbol, like on his heart. Right? Like just like he smashes his smacks his chest. Like tell Nahoon. Like basically what he says is basically like, hey, get word back to this goblin that like, yo, I'm here, right? Like I'm thinking of you and you know, it's kind of sappy, but they don't have a word for love, but it's like, this is the close. This is what love would be, right? Or like you know, yeah, like...
They only have, like, sexy hate, right?
Yeah. Can I just, you know, at that point, just punch him straight in the face, like, with the intent to break his nose, just right in the face.
I think you've forgotten which cop's which now.
Yeah, I mean, why not? I mean, he's just behind the... He's in the bars, yeah. So, yeah.
Just basically just smash in the face and goes, nobody likes snitches.
All right, then, yeah, then probably the other goblins then overwhelm him and try to, like... They like, basically just, like, start shoving their hands down this guy's mouth trying to get any food left over. They have no shame. No shame at all.
Wow.
My work here is done. Let's
and now the kobolds are like, now we're having a big stew.
Even fatten them up for you. It's on the house.
Yeah.
Was our food that you gave out without consulting with me, the resident chef of the group?
It's sort of like a little child starts stamping his feet.
Gilly. Oh, ye of little faith. Don't you know, nature will always provide for us.
Well, no, I will always provide for us. Nature doesn't do that. Fuck me!
You've got a way with garlic, and I'll grant you that.
Exactly. And spices.
Where does the garlic come from?
My backpack.
I can... sense this won't be a fruitful discussion.
Nice garlic. Well, garlic.
Garlic. God damn it, you're definitely getting the personas. The amount of vegetation puns going on here and fruit.
Decker just walks past and sort of, you know, pats Jilly's head and goes, mine's a Jilly chili tonight, buddy. And walks off into the, you know.
But just, is it really? Do you call her meals Jilly chili? The Gilly chili?
Gilly chili.
God damn it.
Gilly special.
Alright, that's pretty good. So whatever the hobbit our halfling burglar cooks is just called the Gilly chili. Because he doesn't throw everything together and it's pretty good. Alright, I love that. I love that a lot. Oh man, that's really good. Not as good as though the heretical branch though. I still feel like that one was anyways, yeah. Alright.
My friends. How are we? Is it time? Should we press on?
No, let's visit the armory.
For your weaponry.
What the kobolds have?
Sorry?
Boy, yeah. Kobolds just have a bunch of spears. They bring you over. They walk you through the that hall of all the columns with all the dragons that are like weaved around the columns, right? And they bring you into this larger great hall area. And in this great hall, you can see there's a bunch of like younglings around, right? Like a bunch of young I don't know what you call baby kobolds, right? But you know, like the moms, like this is like the colony part, right?
Cobblets.
Yeah, little cobblets. There's some like smoke. There's some like bonfires going on in this room. It basically looks like a really horrible refugee camp, but it's basically the colony of this place. And like right near the front wall are a bunch of spears. You notice that there's a few traps set up in this room as well. They're pretty like obvious and crude. But they're set up to prevent anybody from getting in if you didn't know better. You know, kobolds are busy here cooking and working, and some drakelings maybe, yeah. Playing in the chamber. And they show like spears. You need spears kill goblins real good.
Do you have a sling?
They laugh.
What?
That's what traps are for. Spears and traps, all you need. And bombs, but we don't have bombs.
Do you have a strip of leather that I can borrow?
Oh, yeah. No, do you actually requisition a strip of leather?
Yeah, I want to make my own sling. If they don't have any slings, then I'll...
Oh, yeah. No, you can make a sling.
Yeah, pieces look like they'd work.
What would that be, peasant?
I was sort of hoping it'd be something else, peasant work.
Peasant or labor? I mean, do you want to do that right now, or do you want to do it when we have some downtime?
Well, I just want to have the supplies with me.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, no, if you want a scrap, yeah, that doesn't take anything. You're asking them for a scrap of leather, and they're like, sure, and like, here you go. Right? Cool. Maybe it's like a piece of armor or something that they give you.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, a water skin.
Oh, yeah, a water skin.
did you lost yours, did you?
No, it was punctured.
Oh, that's right.
They give you, they don't have a water skin, but they certainly have, like, a decanter. Like, or, like, an old wine bottle.
Yeah, sure. I'll toss away one of the mirrors.
Yeah.
Do they have any helmets?
Yeah, no, they do have, they have a corked wine bottle. That's what they have, and it has wine in it.
Okay, I give the mirror, in return, I give the mirror to one of the cobblers.
Oh, okay. As, like, a cool little, as a trade.
Yeah. No, as a trade. Yeah, I make one of the little ones very happy with it, I hope.
That was
it's more like what happens with the goblins when you give one of them that mirror. They immediately throw it on the ground and grab a glass shard and like back everyone off away from it. Like as soon as you give it to them, they're like, mine. Like the kids want to play. And like he takes like the broken mirror now with a shard, like, Get away! It's mine, and get away.
Fight up the shiny pieces.
Bell, was that was your mirror, right?
Yeah. I imagine it was like a hand mirror, right? Well, it was now. Not a shiny piece of steel, because that's less fun. Either way, they use it as a shank to.
We
keep
could
away.
Say that we have glass mirrors in this fun. World, right? Yeah. Let's just do it.
Looking glass. Yeah, it was mine, Gilly. Yeah.
Good. Just checking.
I think.
Alright.
So,
there are some ways out of here. Yeah. I'm sorry, what?
Do they have any helmets over here? Any leather helmets or something that we could grab?
Yeah, there's some, like, crudely fitted, like, goblin helmet stuff. Like.
Yeah, but that'd be, like, small-headed, like...
Yeah, wouldn't do you much.
Mm. I'll grab one.
There's got pieces over there.
I'll grab one in the hopes that. No, wait. First, I frown at Gilly, like, ugh.
Yeah.
And then I grab one of the leather helmets in the hopes that maybe we'll be able to.
Mechanically, it works, but it's just poor quality.
Oh, I'll do it. I'll wear it.
I'll have one as well if they fit.
So, what do we mark this down at? Goblin, like, goblin helmet, or...?
Yeah, there were only, like, two workable helmets. So, that's what my D4 said, so, yeah. I think it makes sense. Because, like, these guys have been raiding the goblins for a while, and you know that. So, they probably have a couple odds and ends here.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, so tell us about the exits.
Yes, so there's a couple spots that they tell you about. One that you noticed kind of when you first got introduced to the queen, one of these exits kind of goes through what the kobolds called trap room. And it's kind of like something that you would end up in Dwarf Fortress, where like the floor kind of gives way, and then they just like hold people captive in there until they die. But they know that on the other side of this sort of like long corridor is the way into goblin territory. But they also tell you about a longer way around, a way back where you first encountered Meepo, like where Meepo led you, like where they had the cage with the dragon that broke free. There's another way into that room that leads into the goblin territory as well. But that's a long way, and the kobolds don't really go that way. And they said that the goblins don't go that way either because they say it's haunted.
So, what does Meepo think? Best
route. Trap room. Meepo knows the way around the traps.
So, if we... You have, I don't have my 10-foot pole anymore to check for traps.
Oh, but I have trap wise. We'll be fine.
Yeah.
Okay, you can be in front.
Sure.
Yeah.
Meeple can be in front, and then I'll be in front.
You'll be in after front.
Maybe yeah. If you want to go in front, you should give the key to someone else.
No, it's safely stored in my backpack now. It's such a hassle to take it out. It's fine.
Okay, so how about I carry? Can you actually carry a backpack?
Like, yeah, you can, but it's probably gonna be a test, right? It's like labor. If you want to haul stuff, like haul loot, that's right. Usually a labor test.
Oh, we can. I can conjure up a disc to carry Gilly's backpack while he's testing for.
There's no need.
Well, they know where. Like Meepo can point out where the trap is, right?
Yeah.
But it would be you still have to traverse the hallway and not trigger it. It requires walking this like very very minor catwalk kind of way around where it gives way of the floor. You could like temporarily disable the trap with engineering if you wanted to.
There's no
I want
need.
To go the long way around. I want to see why it's haunted.
That makes zero sense, Arendelle.
Do you trust the kobold?
No, but I trust my own skills.
Okay.
Like what I do. This is literally what I was hired for.
And no, now you're here to make it. You're here to make our food.
You were the cook, right?
Yeah, that's what you just said. You're the party cook.
I thought the older races were braver than all of this. Come on. I'll
exactly.
Lead the way.
Exactly.
And I think
look,
Bryce.
I wanted to go from the start.
He scoops up his backpack, shoulders his shield, and starts,
go on, Meepo, lead the way.
And awesome. And they walk off.
And Gilly's going, yeah, come on, Meepo.
Okay. So you guys definitely are able to make it. Into the trap room, right? Like the guards part ways and the door opens. And you can see this room is like covered in like blood smears. Meepo kind of is leading the way and like tells you guys like to hold. And he starts like going to the far left wall and kind of like walking sideways along that wall. You know, like kind of crab stepping his way with his back to the wall. And he gestures for you guys to follow.
Well, you know, fine, Deckard will sort of slide after it and make a little comment of, Cozy, I like your interior decorator. And slides it over.
Oh, yeah. An effective trap room if there's all this blood here, Deckard. So
I feel like this would require, though, a test to make sure you're able to do it. Because this is part of Kobold's nature to kind of do this. Yeah. Yeah, this would definitely be a dungeoneering op 2 to make sure no one falls in.
Like, I think it's everyone though, right?
Yeah, everyone. It's op 2 because your backpacks and everything are a factor. Well, okay. You also never declare that you have your light on. Do you have your light on again?
Oh yeah. If it, you know when we set out and it's dark, I'll
I assume that. Okay.
That's a character's knowing more than the players do.
Yeah,
thing.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. All right. Yeah, so you have your light on. This would be to cross as an op 2 dungeoneering test.
Now,
is this the same thing as the test with the rope climbing? That one person has the action.
Exactly. Yeah.
Right. Well, dungeoneering 4, so I suggest sort of Decker takes a lean and is like, okay, move like this. You know, shed your weight in the backpack like that. So.
I will help with trap wise.
For a party of adventurers, it should be a little higher than, shouldn't it?
Yeah, I was gonna say.
It should be 4.
What are the skills to help with, Dungeoneer?
Criminal, laborer, scout, survivor list. Beginner's luck is health. You're negotiating a narrow squeeze, is what you're doing right now.
So I imagine sort of at the start, like, you know, where Meepo's going forward, sort of Deckard and Jilly are sort of doing that quick sort of professional banter of, okay, so what kind of trap is it? Okay, and how much room do we have? Okay, and then, okay, you know, that kind of quick discussion.
But wait, Deckard, not over there. I point out a few steps that are that could possibly be dangerous. I guess that's Scout.
Yeah, helping with Scout.
Yeah. That looks crumbly over there. That's a little mossy. That'll be slippery.
I'm having trouble thinking of how I could help with Survivalist. You did say that was one of the skills, right?
Yes.
Any ideas? Anyone?
That is weird. Let's see.
Good question.
Like, I can see that for natural traps.
Of tool. You could jury rigging a tool to help you.
Oh yeah,
I suppose I will have like survivalist tools, right? I'll have those supplies because I have the skill.
Like using like a Python or something in your hand.
Yeah,
like...
exactly. So I'm thinking he's got like a
give you a
hook, like a small hook that he's using to like chip into the
rope on the side of the wall, and so that we can
There's a bit of kind of like, let's just rig this.
Okay.
Yeah, that should hold.
Sure, then. What are you guys all carrying right now? Right?
Let me see.
Because if you're gonna, like, if you're taking that help, then you can't really be carrying anything because you're using your hands to, like, guide yourself, right?
Good point.
I've got one hand free.
Yeah, one hand free would be enough, yeah.
Cool. I toss away one of those poor quality swords.
Okay. Oh yeah, from the goblins in the first room.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So then I have one hand free.
I have an extra spear. Can I give that to Meepo, or is he already sort of laden?
He's got a spear.
Well, I'd like to give it to him to sort of, you know, hold for me while, you know, if he can cross with it or whether he has the space.
Yeah, you throw it over to the other side, you know, and clamors on the floor.
You throw it at Meepo.
He's like, gosh.
He's an ex-Meepo now.
Spare field, sir. No, fine. That works then. In that case, I have a hand free. So we roll, I guess?
Yeah.
So that would be a standard test.
Who's leading it? Yeah.
I think Deckard is.
Yeah.
I think Arendelle's going second to
help. Yeah.
To scout, and I think he's telling Grice to stay really close because he's not sure that Grice will have the same observation skills as.
What do your elven eyes see?
Very much so.
All right.
And what, like, our light source is the lantern.
Yes.
So for the person testing, is it a factor? Do we have dim light? Is that?
Depends.
No, because the room's small enough and it really lights for three people.
Right.
It's enough.
Yeah.
I'm a generous god.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're talking dungeoneering test, then I get the three die from all of you helping.
Yes.
Okay. Obstacle was 4?
Yeah.
Yes.
How many dice are you rolling?
You can add dice with fate. No, sorry, with persona.
Well, dungeoneer is 4, and the extra dice is 3, so that's 7 for 4. 7-4, obstacle 4. That's going to be tricky.
It's tricky.
Well, I have Born of Earth and Stone. I don't know if that would help out. You know, knowledge of caves and stone and that kind of thing.
That's a trait, right?
Yes.
Yeah. But this isn't really a cave, though, is
my it? My nature involves delving.
Yeah, no, absolutely. You could help with nature.
This is delving.
This is delving as shit.
If your nature's better than your dungeoneer, use that.
Oh yeah.
No, but
I'm a nature's only better.
Yeah, but you could
use a persona point. Add your nature.
You could use a, yeah.
That's better because if you use your nature, then other people can't help as well.
I guess that's, I mean, this is risky. Just having 7 rolls for 4 successes, I think that's risky.
No, but you can spend a persona to add your nature to the...
Exactly. That's why I think that would be, you know, that's my last persona, but I think it'd be worth it to make sure we get across safely. So that would be 5 extra, so...
No problem. You've got this in the bag.
Let me do this again now. So this is name the test, Dungeoneer, roll the stats, Dungeoneer, traits, that is 3 plus 5, that's 8 extra. Obstacle 4. Oh god, let's do this!
Oh my god, what? You rolled 4 ones.
You're kidding me.
Are you sure you did this test correctly? Yeah.
Wow. Oh my god. So you all end up falling into the fucking trap.
Well, except for me, right?
Yeah.
Wait. Do you have any sixes? I can't see.
No, there's no sixes.
No, there's no sixes. It would turn blue, I think, if there were sixes. Because then you have mixed.
Yeah. What's the thing to reroll a die?
I think it might be a persona.
It might, might not.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, if you're using a wise, you can reroll.
Well, I think, not but... that way.
Nope.
Oh man. Wait, I have a trait, Born of Earth and Stone. Is there any way to use a trait like that to sort of...
You could have given that yourself an extra die for and invoking that trait. Yeah.
Why didn't we use that?
You asked and then there was no response.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I figured that wasn't it.
No, like, you could... it's your job as a player to weasel your traits in whenever appropriate.
Well, no, as I asked that one, but, you know...
This was your last persona, right?
Yep.
Oh,
it's the second persona.
So you can't use, of course.
That's what I was thinking.
So, Alex, you were the only person not helping, right?
I was helping.
Oh, no, you were helping with survival. That's right.
Yeah.
Everybody was helping.
So you guys all suffer.
No, I'm not affected.
Well, because...
using trap wise.
That's it.
Oh, yeah.
You insulate yourself by helping with a wise.
All right. Well, everyone else then will make it, but they take hungry and thirsty, right? You take the condition.
So we all get hungry and thirsty?
Yeah. But after talking, except for obviously Alain, who had the wise, but like after talking with the goblins, seeing Alex, maybe your stomach starts rumbling after eating a little bit of that ration.
Actually.
Yeah. Well, Grice. Yeah, so I think you guys all end up getting hungry and thirsty and make it across the trap. But your lantern goes out.
Oops.
And
I am out of lamp oil.
Your commotion of trying to get around that trap and all, and you definitely hear the sounds of goblins coming up from the next room. The sounds of your stomach's rumbling, the trickling of light until there's no more as your lantern runs out of oil.
Well, Grice immediately strikes a torch, right? Like, he pulls a torch out of his pack and lights that.
Okay.
Isn't this just marvelous?
Look, if you would have just listened to me and stepped wherever I stepped along the wall, then you guys would have been fine. But no, you chose to not listen to me.
You would have stopped distracting me with the constant nattering.
Nattering? Knowledge, not nattering. Knowledge.
Quiet.
There's goblins. Shh.
Look, I know they're coming from there. Relax.
Yeah. So, you guys are kind of like in an L-shaped corridor. Behind you is sort of like the door into Trapland, and in front of you is another sturdy wooden door. Darkness is obviously coming from beneath the door. So there's no lights on, but you definitely hear the sounds of like scurrying of footsteps.
Can I check whether the door is unlocked? Sort of feel around it.
Oh yeah. It's locked.
Good. Then we just wait.
How long do you want to wait?
Till the goblins leave. They're moving out, right?
Okay. Well, then your torch burns out, and like you guys are still waiting there. You know,
wait.
They're not going anywhere.
We didn't advance the grind, so the torch does not burn out.
You're just permanently in this loo zone.
Well, I mean, if they're walking past, then my first instinct would be to sort of listen and wait until they.
No, they were walking towards us, right?
Yes.
Oh, all right. Okay, so I missed that.
So the more you wait, the more the smell from behind that room creeps into this room. It's a stench of garbage, rotten meat.
I don't know about you, but I'm hungry, and
you're hungry.
Ruin my appetite. I'd rather stop and eat something now.
We have time to make a proper meal, Grice. So. Get yourself together, and we move on, and then we get an appropriate time. I can cook you a nice meal.
It's out of character.
Doesn't someone have a check so we can make camp?
Yeah, I do. I have a check.
It would be really good idea to spend it because we're about to hit another notch on the grind.
We're
going to be exhausted.
Yeah, but we're not gonna. But it doesn't make sense to camp in front of this door when there's all.
Yeah, it's super dangerous for camp, right?
It's locked.
It's locked.
Yeah,
but who says they don't have a key?
True.
No, well, no. I imagine it's locked against them, because this is where all the traps are. This is where the kobolds are trying to protect the entrance.
No, it's locked. It's so, I mean, you try the door, right? It's locked on the other side, right?
Okay.
So there's two ways to approach these goblins. Either arms drawn and... aggressively, or you know, maybe I can
sneakily unlock the door and I have my thief tools.
Yeah,
I can use a criminal to unlock the door. That wouldn't be a problem.
Let's establish one thing though. We've seen those vicious and vile animals in the cage over there. There's going to be no reasoning with them. There's going to be stabbing them again. And if one of them's alive, ask them a question and then stab them again.
There's no way for us to spend rations now to get rid of Hungry Thirsty.
Yeah, we can.
Yeah, you absolutely could spend rations for now.
But it's inefficient, right?
Yeah. It's like a one-to-one basis.
One-to-one ratio,
yeah.
I mean, I have 6 preserved rations and 1 fresh ration.
You're not going to eat my rations.
No, I still have 3 of my own.
Well, I think while you guys are... while you're discussing things and sort of plotting, Grice opens up one of his parcels and he just starts shoveling food into his face. And as usual, he eats like a starving man who's never seen food. It's just like all over him and he's got like crumbs sticking to him. And
so we're discussing this and Gilly sort of hears you wolf down this meal and he sort of turns around. So it's like,
I hate it when he does that.
Nope. Deckard looks at this, looks at Gilly, is like, fine, we're doing this, and just sort of, you know, starts snacking like vile rations, like, just eating away.
All right, yeah, you guys inefficiently consume your rations.
You want one from my pack, Angel?
Yeah.
I mean, it's just such a shame. I could cook you a brilliant meal, but you guys, you're so impatient.
It's okay, Gilly, it's okay. I'll wait. I can wait.
Good.
You get an extra helping when I make camp.
Of the old Gilly chili when you make camp.
Oh man, I want Gilly Chili.
Too bad, you can steal cookies.
Okay.
I go like this to Gilly. Oh.
Okay.
Thank you, young one.
Lift up those arms and get ready.
So you have a torch lit right now. You have one thing to go before the grind.
Yeah.
What do you
I want to unlock the door.
Yes.
All right. That'd be a criminal test. Assuming you're using the light given from the torch.
Yeah, if Bryce is standing next to me, then...
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. I think unlocking this door is probably just like what an op 1 criminal test. It's not like these doors are old. They're not necessarily like made to be bank vaults, right?
Simple lock?
Yeah, it's a simple lock.
Do I use thieves tools as supplies here?
No, you don't consume your thieves tools. That's a possible twist.
Do I get a die from them?
Yes, I believe so. I believe thieves' tools do grant you additional die on these tests.
They're consumable, so if you have, I think supplies are usually consumable, right? They provide a one-time one die bonus.
Mm.
But Gilly, you know, I know a bit about these locks, and if you use this. Lock picking tool thing. If you don't use the big one, use the slightly smaller one because this lock looks like one of those old locks that that I used to have in one of my previous homes. And you know, my wife often lost her keys, and I had to pry it open. I had to hire a locksmith, and he always. This one. So I think you should use this one, and I'm going to help you with Scholar.
All right.
Okay. It doesn't say anything about the thieves' tools being consumed when using.
No, it doesn't.
So I don't think they do.
Well, you can totally use them. I'll be taking the help from Arendelle.
Just to be spiteful, Deckard's going to be there with this criminal-wise, just... constantly making comments again about no, just to the left, to the left. No, wait until you hear the click. Tell him all the things he already knows, but sort of.
All right, so that's three. Is Grice helping?
I don't know of a way that I can help.
Really. Scout and Scholar.
Yeah, I don't have either of those. Right. So I have Scholar. I have Scholar. What am I talking about? I think Grice remarks about the construction of the door. And the likely probability that it's locked from this side, and you can tell because of the woodwork that it was made by a left-handed carpenter, and you know he talks about the wood of the door, and you can see that this is a particular type of tree that you only find in this part of the world, and
that makes perfect sense. You knowing wood lore, yeah, totally. Yeah.
So that's four helping dice, and you guys are telling me all this stuff, and I'm sort of working on the door, and at one point
that's the best part. I know, my god.
So I'm gonna use the loner trait against myself.
We are like the most like annoying cynical party ever. Like, this is a mahogany door. Like, let's be careful here.
Is what I do. So shut up and let me do my work.
I'd shut up if you do your work properly. My God.
Yeah, but proper work with a mahogany door. Me.
All right, here we go.
Just imagine the goblins on the other side going.
Oh yeah. The door opens, and
when I say shut up, and then you hear like click. That's the moment when I get it.
Yes. The grind goes over. You guys all take the next condition.
Which is exhausted, right?
No.
We lift it hungry, thirsty.
Yeah, so that's right.
Thirsty again.
Yes. But if you had hungry and thirsty, now I think you take exhausted.
Yeah, that's right.
Where's the quick reference page for those, by the way?
It's on the character sheet, which is on the background to roll 20.
Oh yeah, well, I have to look at that, so. Okay, cool. Yeah, so you guys look into this room, and it makes abundant sense where that stench was coming from. The stench of garbage, rotten carrion, and half-eaten legs of strange animals speak of the years of the use by unsanitary tenants. Tattered hides from 6 unstable hammocks around and a much-used fire pit. Battered cooking equipment lies mixed indiscriminately with broken or worn arms and armor. In this room, you can see that there are 6 menacing goblins, all wearing, in some kind of way, the symbol of the Joker kind of symbol, you know, the crudely drawn goblin face ones. And they all grimace. They all kind of like snarl. And you see that they're not armed with spears. They're armed with like cudgels and like saps. And you also see that a couple of them have like manacles hanging from their belt and rope. looks like they want to capture some prisoners.
Who was the goblin that we spoke to that did the whole that thing in the cage?
I don't remember. Guy with the yep. bloody hat. We didn't ask for names or anything.
No. One of them said like
he said fine. Name. No, he said okay.
Tell Nahum.
Yeah. Tell Nahum. Oh,
yeah. It's all Nahum. Yeah.
Well,
you're thinking to parlay?
This poor party member's going, Nahum! Nahum!
No. I wanted to go like, Nahum says hi, and then just stab one of them. Just.
Okay.
But,
Yep. So let's go to a break. And we'll come back and do this conflict, guys. Or maybe, actually, it is 1:30. Can we play for like another hour? Is that good, everybody? Is that too late?
It's okay for me.
All right, cool. Yeah, let's go for a break. Because otherwise, I was like, maybe we should just wrap up. But like, yeah, let's do it. Let's go for a break. So we'll be back in 5 minutes.